Today is a news day. Hey, Beetlebugs. The first thing I want to talk about is The Beatles, The Lost Concert, which is a film that was supposed to premiere last week, which didn't happen. And then it was supposed to premiere in a bunch of theaters around the United States this week, which, not this week, next week, which didn't happen. So that's sad. They're gonna try to push off the premiere date to later in the summer, so let's hope that happens, and let's hope they give us an official date soon, because I really, really want to see it! I want to see the Beatles on the big screen, because how cool would that be? I haven't had the chance to do that yet. I'm sure a few of you might have seen A Hard Day's Night or Help or something in theaters, which is something I want to do. That would be so cool! It would be like seeing it for the first time ever again. That'd be great. If you don't know what The Lost Concert is, it is a documentary on Beatlemania and the events that led up to Beatlemania. It talks about Brian Epstein's efforts and the phone call from Sid Bernstein and the Ed Sullivan Show and then their first official concert in Washington, D.C., which is actually The Lost Concert. I didn't know that until not too long ago when I looked it up. And I was like, wait a second, but you can watch the whole thing on that, the U.S. Visit DVD that was created by those two brothers who traveled with the Beatles on their first U.S. visit. The thing about The Lost Concert is that it was filmed by a different company, and they had 8 cameras, so it's supposedly better quality, where with the two brothers who traveled with the Beatles, I'm guessing there was only 2 cameras. And they also interview some really cool people, some of which were there. They had fans who actually attended the concert. They had interviews of them, and then they had an interview with a woman who lived around the Washington, D.C. Coliseum, which is where the Beatles played, and so she gives her take on what experiencing Beatlemania is like. They also have interviews with Sid Bernstein and Tommy Rowe. Tommy Rowe was this singer who opened for the Beatles at the Coliseum. They also interview, like, Steven Tyler, The Strokes, Duffy, Joe Perry, a bunch of people. West End is putting on a musical called Let It Be, which is supposed to commemorate the anniversary of the release of Love Me Do many years ago. And the premise of the musical is just following the Beatles singles throughout the eras of the Beatles' career. And they're gonna have footage to enhance the whole experience, and then they're gonna have, of course, a band. It's gonna be like a tribute band, basically. Just a stagnant tribute band, stays in one place, where most tribute bands make a tour. But I know Rain had had a show on Broadway, so I guess it's kinda like that. They're putting together the band right now, sort of-ish. They just held the auditions, and I think they might have some more auditions coming up to see who's gonna play the Beatles. So that's pretty cool. Also, Ringo Starr and Dave Stewart of the Eurythmics are putting out a movie. They're gonna be the executive producers of a movie called Hole in the Fence. I almost said Fixing a Hole. Jeez, you know you're obsessed with the Beatles when? It's a drama about a few kids who put together a band to escape their mining town. Which, you know, kinda sounds like the Beatles. Kind of, except they're more of a seaside town, so lots of seaside. I don't know where I was going with that. If you guys aren't familiar with the TV show Mad Men, it is a drama that takes place in the 1960s. One of the creators, shut up! You have nothing to contribute to this discussion. No, you don't. You don't watch TV. You don't! You watch TV on the internets. That doesn't count. To be honest, I don't watch Mad Men either, but he's a cat. He really doesn't have a place here. I'm sorry. We'll have Catterday one day. I know I'm not Saturday anymore, but we could still have Catterday, and someone came on Skype. No, you're gonna have to wait. Today can't be the day. Okay. So... You keep making me lose my train of thought, Jiggy. The creator of the show, Mad Men, thought the show was never really complete because he couldn't include a Beatles song or Beatles performance in it at all because it's just too expensive. Licensing for Beatles crap is just really expensive. And they finally did put a Beatles song in their show, Tomorrow Never Knows, which is really cool because normally it'd be something really popular and, you know, that's cool and everything, but it kind of gets, boring after a while, because it's just like, okay, well, She Loves You, Hey Jude, but Tomorrow Never Knows, that's a really unique track, so it's really cool that they used that track specifically in the show. and it costs $250,000 to do so. The creator of Man Man actually tried getting Beatles songs on the show before, but AppleCore declined his requests. So last week I was going to start this thing. I was going to post one video every week on my personal channel, Nez McAham, to make it up to you guys who are mad at me for not posting much the last 5 months. Which I'm sure there's no one mad at me, but just in case you are, I'm sorry. Please don't be mad at me anymore. I'm only human. I make lots of mistakes. Basically, just gonna post one video a week to this week to make up for last week after promising I was gonna make a video. I suck. I really suck. So if you're interested in that, hop over to my channel, Nez McAham. I will post a link or something or annotation or whatever. And hopefully I will have 2 videos up this week. If you have any ideas for a vlog, if you want me to talk about something or do something, like, just ask me. Comment on this video, comment on the video I posted on Nez McAham last week, which is just an intro video. I suppose that could count as last week's video. I hope. But I think I mentioned, yeah, there's gonna be another video this week. And there's not going to be, because that week passed. Unless I could go back in time. In which case, I would have something to talk about, unless I want to keep it a secret. We should probably end this now before I ramble on some more. Bye, Beetlebugs! You know I feel-